want to give you three reasons on why you might want to consider doing a hybrid event in 2022. Number one is accessibility. This is incredibly important for nonprofit organizations that are really looking to spread the message of inclusivity. This allows you to be inclusive with, you know, your donors that have the propensity and the capacity to give. Number one, they might be traveling. Number two, there might be people that geographically are not able to physically attend your events, but they see something online or they see one of your videos or perhaps they see a call to action or a friend shared something and they really are interested in your organization, but if you're not providing them another way for them to access your event, you're missing out on that opportunity. So number one is accessibility. Number two is that the analog generation, the baby boomers that remember a time before the internet, they're phasing out. In 10 years down the road, they're gone. So what are you starting to do now to sort of cultivate and steward this next level generation and consumer, which is 140 million Americans alone that are of this digital age? They don't remember a time before the internet, and they're demanding an entirely new way of engaging with your brand and your organization in an online environment. You think of NFTs, non-fungible tokens, the metaverse. There's so many things now where this is a digital consumer and they wanna engage with brands in digital ways. So number two is appealing to this new generation. Number three is that your content will live and breathe on even well beyond your event experiences. So now we're recording all this content in your events, this engagement. You've got intellectual capital, which is people connecting and learning together. You have social capital, people coming together and having a great time, and communal capital, which is this feeling of this transcendent purpose that is all happening in the four walls of your event experience. And we can take that content and break it up into usable content that you could put blogs around and use it in your post-event follow-up strategy to engage people for maybe excitement for a future event. So now you have all of this content that's working for you, even beyond your event concluding.